What is divine intervention? Exodus 3, 7 to 9. Let's hurry up. What is divine intervention? Exodus chapter 3, 7 to 9. I'll read verse 7 and we'll read 8 together. Ready? And the Lord said, I have surely seen the affliction of my people, which are in Egypt, and have heard their cry by reason of their taskmasters, for I know their sorrows. Verse 8, let's read together in concert. 1, 2, read. And I am come down to deliver them out of the hands of the Egyptians, and to bring them up out of that land unto a good land and a large, unto a land flowing with milk and honey, unto a place of the Canaanites and the Hittites and the Amorites and the Perizzites and the Hivites and the Jebusites. Verse 9. Now therefore, behold, the cry of the children of Israel is come unto me, and I have also seen the oppression wherewith the Egyptians oppress them. What is a divine intervention? A divine intervention occurs when God steps in over the affairs and the issues of our lives. A divine intervention occurs when God steps in over the affairs and the issues of our lives, influencing circumstances and situations to turn out for the good of His people. I'll take it again. Divine intervention is said to occur when God steps in over the affairs and the issues of our lives, influencing circumstances and situations to turn out for the good of His people. That is what we call a divine intervention. When God steps in over the affairs and the issues of our lives, influencing circumstances, influencing situations to turn out for the good of His people. It is usually an act of deliverance from negative circumstances or conditions. Divine intervention is an act of deliverance from negative circumstances, negative conditions. I wrote something here and I want you to listen. He does this, God now. God does this as an act of His mercy, an act of His love, and an act of His sovereign power. Why does God step in to intervene? He does this as an act of His mercy. He does this as an act of His love. He does this as an act of His sovereign power. When God steps in over the affairs of my life, over the affairs of your life, over the issues in my life and your life, influencing circumstances and situations to turn out for the good of His people. And I said that He does this as an act of His mercy, an act of His love and sovereign power. Who is expecting God to do that tonight? To step in. Step in. Push everything and step in. And say, I have come to fight a battle my child cannot fight. I've come to deal with an issue that is beyond the believer's power. Why do we need divine intervention? One clear reason, and I want you to listen. Why do we need divine intervention? I wrote here, and please listen, then you write. There are certain situations and circumstances we find ourselves in that are beyond our ability as humans to influence or change. This is the primary reason why we need divine intervention. Because there are certain situations, there are certain circumstances that we find ourselves in that are beyond our ability as humans to influence or to change. There are certain circumstances and situations that we find ourselves in as humans that are beyond our ability to influence for the good and our ability to change. These circumstances can be caused by our ignorance and carelessness. These circumstances can be caused by human factors beyond our control. Or these circumstances can be demonically engineered. I'll take it again. That these circumstances that are usually beyond our control, necessitating a divine intervention, can be caused by, number one, the presence of carelessness or ignorance. Because carelessness or ignorance from scripture can lead men to pain, lead men to difficulty and self-inflicted negative situations. But number two, these circumstances necessitating divine intervention can be caused by human factors which are beyond our control. Human factors. God gave every man a will. Are we together? And God will not usurp the will of men. He will allow men to choose. Now, the only problem is that sometimes in making their choices, it can have an effect on you. Are we together now? For instance, if a grandfather or a father gets up to go and consult powers and writes the name of all his children and says, I want this shrine to protect them. You were not there. God respected the choice of that man, the choice to be evil. But then unfortunately, you can become a victim of the choices and the decisions of other people. Hallelujah. The Bible is full of many innocent people who still suffered. I give you an instance. The daughters of Job did not choose to go to Sodom and Gomorrah. It was the choice that their father made, and they had to follow because they were the daughters. They were about to lose their life, lose their dignity, because they were in a place that was so depraved. It was not a, there's no record in the Bible that their journey to Sodom and Gomorrah was a unanimous decision. Lot made that choice as the head of that family, and he, together with everyone he had, were on their way to Sodom. There are human factors beyond your control. Are we together? If your director decides to do business with armed robbers and the company loses, the company did not lose because of your lack of productivity, but someone who was your superior went on your behalf and transacted business that should not be, and then you become a victim. You need divine intervention. Many of you right now are in many battles you do not even know. You are just seeing stains of blood all over your life, and you cannot know where the enmity is coming from, because those connected to you began certain battles either through carelessness or just the will of men, and you found yourself in the middle of troubles you do not know. There are people today who are in trouble because of the kind of surname that is added to their names. Now, nothing wrong, but perhaps there was a battle somewhere. Are we together now? And just because you carry a particular name, someone will ask you, is it this surname I know? You say, yes, sir. And it's all right, you'll hear from us. That's how you lost the job. The problem was not the first class. The problem was that there was a vendetta that predated your arrival, and you just swept yourself into it. May God arise for you tonight, oh. That the issues around your life that are higher than you, or not the ones that are as a result of your ignorance and carelessness, he will still arise concerning them. But the ones that are due to factors beyond your control, factors beyond your control. Hallelujah. I remember a very humorous story I was told years ago about some of these, our young people who went to sell a property belonging to his mother, and he sold it to a church. They didn't know, the family did not even know he had sold it. They just saw church, and you know church people, they surrounded it and were giving thanks. And the mother saw people around the land lifting their hands and thanking God for this kind of breakthrough. True story. And she wondered, she didn't know that her son, the only son, had gone and he gave it as a giveaway, and the church saw it as breakthrough. It's not their fault. They paid for it, and the boy kept quiet with the thing. Now, that mama is suffering not because she was careless. She's made her investment, but because she had a child who was not thinking well. Are you seeing that now? Another person's carelessness. And the church is rejoicing, giving God thanks. That was what called her attention. Why are people gathered around my land? Because it was not far from the house. They were lifting up hands, giving God thanks for what God had done. Whereas the boy sold the thing, and of course, you know this kind of boy, it will not take 1 month. That money would disappear. Because the prodigal son, we don't know how long before this money disappeared. But the kind of people who were described in his journey can finish anybody's money overnight. May you not see those kind of people. And if they are around your life this night, may God take them far. Listen, the spirit you call a waster does not work by eating anything physical. It brings wrong people into your life. There are people who can finish 100 million in 1 day, 100 million in 1 night. You would think I'm exaggerating. They will be involved in stupid things that destroy it overnight. Satan for you. Hallelujah. So human factors beyond your control. You can be in pain and be a victim of another person's carelessness. One more example on that. Have you heard about the man in the Bible called Jonah? Jonah. Jonah sinned against God. He knew the hand of God was against him. He quietly entered the ship. Did he confess it? No. He just kept quiet. Are we ready to go? I hope you know he was a prophet. So he already knew what would happen. When the storm and all of that started, he was sleeping. The people suspected that something is wrong. All of us are panicking, but somebody here is not participating in this rescue. And they went to wake him. It's in your Bible. Jonah! And he got up. What is wrong? Why are we crying? We are throwing everything and you are keeping quiet. And he still kept quiet. Until they casted lots and it fell on him. And they said, what happened? He said, truly, let me tell you the story. I actually ran away from God. And they said, what do we do with you now? He said, if you really want to be free, throw me out. It was not someone who was cursing him. It was out of compassion. He said, just throw me and leave me with God. We know how we but if I am in this boat, you see, if they were so compassionate and said, Jonah, but you know it's not in our character, they would have all died there. There are times you have to look beyond sentiments and say, Jonah, I love you, but I will be praying for you while you are out of my boat. At least he knew God would send a fish to rescue him. Those other people, did they have that kind of covenant for a fish to rescue them? Did the fish rescue their bags that they threw out? Are we together? Now, I'm saying this because there are people who can afford to be careless because they have elder brothers and elder sisters. They can waste money and say, I'm sorry. But you who is the only person, you will squander the money with them and they will quietly go to all their destiny helpers and lie down and roll while you are suffering on the street. May God give you wisdom this night. I'm showing you why we need divine intervention. That there are times that we become victims of the decisions of people. 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 Number three, there are situations that are demonically engineered. Oh, this is true. Does Satan afflict people? Yes. John 10:10. The thief cometh not but for to steal, to kill, and to destroy. I've taught this endlessly in this place. Satan truly comes to steal. He does not come to discuss. He does not come to negotiate. The moment you see Satan around the vicinity of your life, you can be sure the worst will eventually happen if you leave him there. The worst may not start happening, but eventually it will happen. And let me tell you how Satan operates. He will touch a part of your life and watch your response. When he sees that you are cold, giving excuses, he now re-strategizes and comes again. Give Satan a hole, he will make a door from that hole. Some of you right now, it is because you became careless. Satan attacked you, you kept quiet. You didn't cry for help. You didn't ask God for help. You didn't meet men with the grace to help you. And Satan said, I have discovered that this person is not serious about their destiny. Let me continue. Can I show you one scripture? Acts chapter 12. Give it to us, please. We'll read from verse 1 to 4. I just want to show you a statement. Watch this, everybody. Now about that time, Herod the king stretched forth his hand to vex certain of the church. So Herod wanted to strike the church. The Bible says he killed James, the brother of John, with the sword. Is that in your Bible? I want you to read verse 3. Ready? One to read. And because he saw that it pleased the Jews, he proceeded further. Stop. What did he do? One more time. So it was not his original intention to take Peter, but because he touched James, like he touched your finances, it was not his plan to come to your health, but he touched one area in your life and you did not care. He said, no problem, it's just a human thing. He said, I like this kind of person. He proceeded further. When he proceeded further to take Peter also, the church got angry, and in verse 5, I believe, the Bible says, but prayer, give us 5, was made. Peter was kept in prison, but prayer was made without ceasing of the church unto God for him. In other words, the church said, no, if we keep quiet, it's one by one they will kill all of us. Why do we need divine intervention? There are situations and circumstances that in many regards are way beyond our ability as humans to solve, to influence, to change. Can be a product of our ignorance and carelessness, can be a product of the decisions of men that we have to be victims of. And sometimes it can be demonically engineered. It doesn't matter in what way it has come tonight. In the name of Jesus, you must be free. Shout a believing amen. Ladies and gentlemen, there are things men can do. For instance, men can think. For instance, men can walk. For instance, I can stretch my hands and pick up my Bible. I don't have to be a Christian. That ability is given to all men. It's not a sign and a wonder if my hand moves from a human standpoint. It's not a sign and a wonder if you see me eating. It is given unto men. So there are things when you see, you know that men have done this. But there are things when you see, you know that Satan has done this. Hallelujah. How do you know Satan has visited a life? Because he steals, he kills, and he destroys. You can know Satan has visited a family because he steals, he kills, he destroys. You can know Satan has visited a church, Satan has visited a destiny. But ladies and gentlemen, I have good news for you. There are things only God can do. There are things men can do. There are things Satan can do. In the parable, Jesus came and said, an enemy has done this. But there are things only God can do. And God is determined to do in your life tonight what only he can do. Deuteronomy chapter 26, 6 to 9. I found this scripture and it blessed me mightily. And the Egyptians, evil entreated us and afflicted us. Watch this now. And laid upon us hard bondage. And when we cried unto the Lord God of our fathers, the Lord heard our voice, like he's hearing your voice now, and looked on our affliction and our labor and our oppression. Verse 8. And the Lord brought us forth from out of Egypt with a mighty hand. The only one who can perform that miracle is the one who had that kind of hand. God has the mighty hand, and with an outstretched arm, and with great terribleness, and with signs and with wonders. Verse 9. And have brought us into. I like this scripture. God can bring men out of and bring men into. There are men who can bring you out of trouble, but they cannot bring you into blessings. There are men who can bring you into blessings, but they cannot bring you out of trouble. But there is a hand that can bring you out of and still bring you into. Does that sound like good news for someone? He can bring you out of every curse, every yoke, every demonic orchestration, and then bring you into. Out of, then brings you into. There is a hand that can stop a kidnapper, who is running with your children. You share the testimony of that woman. So such people are on earth. You are not the only one who is waking up. As you wake up, they wake up too. Determined to make your day great, they are also determined to carry your children. And this issue that happened to this our dear sister was not cheerlessness. It was not cheerlessness. Okay, I just want to pick up something, and the man zooms away. I'm sure in his mind he's already calculating. The first child will go for 2 million naira. The second, are anybody bargaining on your head? In the name of Jesus Christ, my God will bury them this night. You don't believe men can bargain on the head of many? Ask Joseph. Were the brothers not bargaining on his head? Ask Jesus and Judas. How much will you give me? And I will give you this man. So he's calculating 2 million for the first child. The one that is a bit grown, maybe 2.5 or 3 million. And then you gather everything. And these wicked, demonic people don't mind killing because something has happened to them. They are under a full influence of the spirit. No man without the assistance of the spirit can be that wicked. I can tell you this. Hallelujah. How about the one who shared a testimony? 75-year-old grandmother, plagued with cancer, and that devil found everything can change depending on what force engages it. Depending on what force. I once watched something, I think it was on YouTube or something. I was just playing around with my time. One heavy crusher. And they keep putting all kinds of things and they watch it crushing it. I can't even remember how I got there. And I was enjoying watching. I mean, you will see things that look strong, but under the weight of that machine, it will crush it into pieces. You see that thing tearing cars, tearing metallic objects. I said, this is power. I needed to see that thing to remind me. Sometimes you need motivation, even if it's from science. That's power. That you put something that is bragging, you can carry this pulpit that claims it is all glass. You bring that thing near that crusher. Non-emotional approach. It will squeeze it into pieces. That's how God is squeezing someone's every oppression over your life. I am under the shadow of your wings. Your influence is all over me. I am under the shadow of your wings. Your influence is all over me.
And the word of God came with power to men, and men received it. We believe that you are blessed via this video. Please, if you are blessed, just do so by subscribing to this channel and click on the notification bell to get daily updates. Please comment, share this video so that others too will be blessed. Thank you.